keep this.
This is where you're supposed to freestyle.
Good night, Charlize. So drop your bars.
This is your bars.
Sound like Scooby-Doo. Sound like reggae. Whoopity-scoop. Yeah, sure. What you want to ask me? Peace, great morning.
Where do I get this time? It's like 1:36.
Nobody can sleep with all these energy going on.
We're the only crackheads.
It's not a crackhead. Hey. I'm just having a nice time with my kids. Watching Charlize dance.
I just fit the stretch.
I'm here.
I don't know nobody. Nah, mommy has this song. I can't play this.
No, I've never heard it.
Yes, you have.
No, I haven't.
You have this song.
I said I haven't.
A, it's my favorite beat.
So drop something. Think as a world as ant. I don't explain. Are you making a statement or are you asking a question? Somebody asking you to break dance, Charlize.
Break dance in a small area?
You can't break dance. You don't bust it behind. She got. What you call that one again?
Shoot.
So she's doing the shoot. Sometimes you have to learn from the young people and do the new dance. So you can feel good and look good and feel great, you know? Go ahead, ask the question. Who says we have to do anything formal to ask a question? Go ahead and ask a question. What's the question? Have I ever thought of? I don't understand the construct of the sentence. So funny how you're talking about ants, because I went to see Godfrey tonight and he was talking about ants. You know, I think ants are one of the most intelligent species on earth. If only human beings can operate and do things that the ants work together. Ants don't be fucking each other over. You know what I'm saying? They work together collectively. But when Godfrey was talking about the ants, he was talking about how there's always a defense mechanism in each and every one of us. So let me show my face. So, you know, just while Charlize is entertaining the other way. When you think about the ants, you know, Brandon, turn on just a little teeny bit. When you think about the ants as a species and other species, they defend themselves. And too often, some of our people, they tend to, like pacify everything instead of just speaking up for themselves, you know, speaking up for ourselves. So, you know, so, but I don't know in what context you're talking about the ants. That's what you're saying? Well, I know that we've all evolved as many species on the earth, you know, from centuries. So we've been the stones, we've been the water, we've been everything, you know. But when you think of ourselves collectively as the insects, you know, the world, how they work together, the bees form the beehive, the wasp and all these things. So it's you know, at some point we got to work together. All right, so I'm going to switch over back to Charlize. If you have any other questions, please feel free to ask.
I'm about to blow the arena. Hold on, wait a minute. Let me bring it back. Hold on, wait a minute. Let me stop.
You're rapping now.
Don't hit on me. Put on my stuff. That's not like an ad. Hey.
So wait, yeah, dance, I'm fixing my tits. So somebody asked, what dance is that?
This is the jerk.
Okay, this is the jerk. It's not subjected to somebody being, it's not as an adjective. So it's 1:41 a.m. in New York. Who else is up again? So let me ask you this now. Why are they still rapping to do it Percocet and think that, even though it's a drug? What's the purpose? What? Yeah, because he's talking about Percocet again also. So what's the purpose? Yes, I heard it 3 times.
Pretty sure he's talking about his jewelry.
Nah. Nah, he's talking about drugs. Keep on interrupting. I heard it.
You know that.
When you listen to that, you got to also pay attention to what the words are saying and what it means. You love my daughters. That Charlize, you have a compliment. Said, hey, hold on. The compliment, he says, she loves your, the goddess rising, love your dancing soul. She loved to dance like our mama, our mother. We love to dance. Someone made a comment and said, she's the goddess rising, love her dancing soul. Even when I'm talking to her, she's sometimes, we just be jigging and dancing around me. You know, because I always talk about... Just because you dance doesn't mean something's wrong with your brain.
I make my own music, that's my point.
Yeah, but be conscious of what you're saying about there's something wrong with it just because you look.
I don't know.
You're just doing things differently. That's all there is. That's what's going on. Yeah. That's what it is. That's what it is. So this is how I connect and relate to my tribe. Just chilling. And we don't usually sleep anyway, so hey, what the heck? All these things are changing, you know, on the earth. We're not conformed to time. Because there's no such thing as time. Just an illusion.
Looking for instrumental songs?
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh.
Time for us to raise what? The bar?
What?
I think too much things is raising right now, so it's time to lower some things and raise some things. Raise the bar, raise how we speak, raise consciousness, yeah. Mm-hmm. For sure.
I'm gonna click it right now.
What are you looking for?
I'm gonna click the one that I like the cover to. It's Rugrats.
Yeah.
So Brandon, what message would you like to tell my Facebook friends? You know, sometimes it's good to hear from the other generation, you know, thoughts, ideas. He's so determined to get into his speech class, so he's now doing speech. Yes. And what were you doing in your speech class today? How did you do today or yesterday?
Pretty mediocre.
And why did you do mediocre?
I messed up in my mindset.
And why did you mess up?
Because
what? Because you never paid attention?
No.
You didn't put too much energy into it?
I did, but it was
then like, what?
It's a lot of explaining. You'd have to be there, you know.
Get in front of me. I kind of know why.
A lot of explaining.
But wait, or you're going to walk away, I'm going to tell you to give the message.
What message am I giving?
A message.
Whatever message comes to you. Okay, Charlize has a message. Sometimes it's good to hear what our young people have to say.
It's better to do things when you feel motivated or inspired rather than forcing the creativity.
Yeah.
If you know what I mean.
Like what?
Like, say I'm drawing something or I'm making a painting. I must have the inspiration. I should never force myself to draw something if I know I just don't feel it. Just like writing lyrics. If you don't feel it, don't force yourself to do it.
And is there a point to, you know,
if you're not
ready
to do something, don't force it upon yourself. Mm-hmm. Wait until you know you're ready.
But do you believe in exerting your talents and your gifts?
No.
Are we going to talk to?
Yes, mother.
No. Yes, mother. I'm asking you.
Go.
Do you feel that it's important to exert your talents and your gifts no matter what?
Yes, because then that'll be a waste of life and then you have to come back another time and then you'd be like, oh man, this sucks.
And I would love to know what is your take on education in this country?
In this state, going to school. Trash.
Why is it trash?
Because the way they do their format is just trash.
Like in what way?
Like Common Core, that is the dumbest thing to ever be created. I don't think any other state has that. No other state has that but New York. New York State.
Where how do you know? You ever checked out the other states?
No, we're the only people who have it. That's why everybody else has life so much easier.
Well, no one says it's ever easier because if you didn't experience it in other places, you don't know.
Like, when it comes to our school, they think they were smart by extending
our school
classes.
Or you mean the system?
Our school.
They thought they were smart by extending class time to how much?
So 55 minutes.
55 minutes and having us have lunch for 20 minutes and 3 minutes to get to class, even though we have classes at each end of the school.
Mind you,
and somehow they think we're
gonna can't keep students in class.
So when before they made that decision, did they do a poll and ask students what how they
feel? No, they did not. They just enforced rules, and they're like,
they just enforced rules. You know, what's interesting is that I even had recorded in the book that, you know, the children are the ones that are going to be taking over now because, you know what, most of the adults don't listen. They don't pay attention to the experiences. See how everything is just repeating and all the bullshit and all the nonsense. The things that should be taught. Do you think that they would, you know, I was saying this to someone that I did a reading for today because I told him that his path is that he's going to be mentoring like a YMCA thing, you know, after school or something, because children are getting to be more stimulated with what they desire to do and to be. And it may not necessarily be tied to reading the books that they provide as far as their curriculum, because they're not teaching them or talking about opening up your chakras, connecting to your pineal gland, and what does it mean to be activated and all these things. What does it truly mean as far as this ascension? You know, they're not having that table talk and all these kind of things. You know what I'm saying? None of these things. They just want to keep regurgitating the same thing over and over again.
They don't
and sometimes
people skills.
People skills.
That's it. What are you talking about? How is me just talking to a big group of people at all giving me people skills? Like being social. Like they even did a study where they're like most kids who are like going into school, they're not social. Like literally my teacher, right? You know Mr. Heim, right? Like social studies, right? Our class is always participating, and then the new freshmen are like, oh, he's so mean. Because they don't participate. Like, we were literally like, do you talk in class? They're like, oh, no, we don't.
Pretty sure you were like that last year.
No, I wasn't. I just didn't like him. What are you talking about?
I love when my children debate and talk.
Compared to my new social studies teacher, yes. But I didn't, I don't.
Social studies teacher, I'm snagging. It's not very.
You know, even my godson, he lives in Pennsylvania, and he's the same age as Brandon. They're just a few months apart. What? No, but you're the same age. You're born the same year. And he can't even get to graduate the same time as Brandon this year because of the curriculum in Pennsylvania laws, because they go by age. And he's so brilliant. He's so intelligent. You know what I mean? So all these rules and stuff, I'm telling you, even the educational system is going to start to break down even more, where children in schools, it should be based on what specific English, or it's required for English and required for Spanish or required for economics. It's mostly, to me, what's going to be happening is based on their talent and their gifts. Their talents and their gifts. So it's important to encourage our children, because they're bored. They're bored, and they shouldn't be labeled as ADHD and all that foolishness, and be medicated just because they're bored and they want to do more than what's being taught in schools, you know? So even my own daughter has said to me she's tired of, you know, she don't like school and all that stuff, you know what I'm saying? Because she just doesn't connect to it anymore, you know? So she's still going to be going, but at the same time, I still encourage my children to be themselves and to be who they are. So right now, Brandon has created his own Instagram Mimi page. They don't like when I say Mimi. Look what his face. He gets so tight when I say Mimi page or main page, whatever.
Why do you do it?
And because I love doing that. I love trolling you. Just like I think it's very funny. So anyway, he has his own Mimi page, and so people of his peers, I should say, are following him, because what he does, he's bringing in his own jokes. You know, some of them I don't really get, but it, you know, but like I said, excuse me,
you shouldn't get them.
You wouldn't get them.
What do you mean I wouldn't? I didn't say all of them. I said some of them.
Most of them you wouldn't.
What?
Most of them you wouldn't get.
Okay, but where do you think that places you right now for yourself in this time? Being that you have all these followers, where does it place you right now, do you think, with all those people, those young people that follow you?
I don't know.
You don't know?
You could be public figure.
Because you're like an advocate of something. So you have your followers. What was interesting is that Charlize was telling him the other day that it's not how many followers he has that makes him sociable. You see what I'm saying? So, Charlize, tell people again what makes them sociable. What's the difference between how you do things and how you can relate to being sociable in versus people who have a whole bunch of followers and how they connect?
Bluntly, you're able to talk for, you know, at least a minute and not stop awkwardly, you know, not look a person in their eyes when they're talking to you, act awkward. No, some people are awkward, and it doesn't mean they're not social, but, you know, some people, because they're just always on their phone, you know, giving literally little kids tablets and everything, they literally don't even know what a human is. They only know what computer is and YouTube, so they don't know how to talk at all, and it's kind of sad.
Well, you know what? That's only because of their upbringing and how they either interrelate with each other. So, you know, so it's important to be able to relate, you know, with one another, including with our children, because they have something to share and to give. So when I interact with my children, I'm just being myself completely, because that's what they love about me. And what was one of the things that I had asked you guys years ago? I said, if anybody stop you on the street and they ask you about your mama, what you gonna say? And they said,
You're blunt. You're blunt.
I'm blunt.
You're real.
I'm real.
You yell.
And I yell. What else?
Really loud.
She said I yell really loud.
You enforce chores.
I enforce chores. Oh.
Yeah, we clean and dust.
Uh-huh. And what, Brandon, what do you have to say about me?
You're pretty cool.
I'm pretty cool.
You're a cool mom.
Yes.
Oh. And what makes me cool?
Because
of the temperature?
No, you're not strict, unlike some parents I know.
Like who? Who like, are you compare?
Don't even let their kids use Instagram or.
Oh yeah.
Anything? I'm like, that's sad.
Yeah. So in other words, I don't keep it on lockdown that much, right?
Yeah, I think you low key let us raise ourselves.
I let you raise up because why?
We're kind of like Jewish kids.
Because I don't. Because I don't give a fuck.
You know that's what they do, right? Like their kids raise their kids. I see it.
Yeah. And usually people who have a lot of kids, they usually don't have their own kids because they're already raising their siblings.
What do you mean?
You know? Meaning that like take your brother, your oldest brother, for instance. He hasn't had any children, but I would think because of the fact that he knows what it means to raise children, so therefore they would really take their time before they would do something like that.
Yeah, because you know they understand how hard that would be, and how financially stable you must be in order to have a child.
Mm-hmm. Well, they say it takes a village to raise a child.
It also takes money.
Yeah, it takes money, but it takes a village more than the money. It takes a village. Yes, it does. It's you know, even, you know, I was thinking about something back in the times where it was in ancient Kemet and all the other villages of the world when things started. It wasn't just one parent that was raising the child. It was the people in the village, you know. Even when my daughter-in-law, my son, came and spent the weekend. Spent the weekend with me, like, in donkey years from before Remy was even here. And it takes off pressure off of the couple and even yourself when, you know, because even if I have my grandkids by myself, it's a lot of work. It's a lot of work because by the time you think you change one pamper and you go to the next day, this one hungry, they got to feed yourself. And it's like at some point you start to feel resentful. And even with my children at whatever age they are, I still have to use my energy in raising them, you know, and still it takes a village to raise a child. So we need to address what it means for parents who, you know, especially the mothers who go through postpartum depression, when they feel like as if they want to kill their children, because this is something that's within the system. Because if you ever known something that's within, I forget what they call it, within the genetics of any species, that sometimes they want to kill their own children. But I just think it's some type of a chemical makeup in there, because still working together, that's why I should be working together as a community. Not only do we build upon things for the children, but we build upon things even for ourselves. And it brings on things that are much healthier in the environment for the child to be able to not only adapt, but that they're able to be themselves, comfortably be themselves. You know what I mean? And not told how they shouldn't be or what they shouldn't be. So, but we're breaking the barriers to all of this. And I always allow my children to be themselves, but at the same time, I let them have their own voice, but then they have to still honor me as a, because even this week alone, I had issues with the three of them. Oh yes, I do. So anybody who knows me or how I am as a parent, I don't play. I keep it very, very real. But I don't put fear out there with my kids, and I don't put them, lock them in a space and stuff like that. I don't put any projections onto them as far as if anything should happen to them or whatever. Even with Charlize, I'm talking about, you know, appreciate the clothes that I buy for her, because the clothes that I buy for her, she don't wear some of that shit. So I cuss her ass out. And guess what? My beautician, she said the same thing happens with her daughter. So, you know, I know everybody has different ways how they raise their kids in different cultures and stuff like that. But there is something about where we can be when it comes to the child appreciating the parent and the parent appreciating the child for who they are, because we're all growing and interacting with one another. And there's also a bond and an intimacy that you create even with your children, just as much as it would be with your spouse. And I've always put it out there, even when I was married to my ex-husband, and I told him, I said, I don't feel as if everyone is supposed to always be under each other's ass every single day. There's, you know, you balance things out. You take time to nurture yourself. You allow your children to also take their time within themselves. And also you take time with whoever you're with, and everything just balances, you know, within each other. So all the pressure is not on one person or one family and all that stuff. You know, you check up on people who have babies and stuff like that, and young children, and see what you can do to, you know, to, because during this course of this awakening, it's getting to be more intense. And even getting triggered even with the children too, because the children are also going through their own triggers. They're going through their own awakening. You know, if that child has a certain illness, it's because 9 times out of 10, that was something that they were taking on from a past life also that they carried into this life, you see? So, very important to listen to what the children are saying. Listen to what they're saying, because there are messages that are coming through from them also. They're in place also to hold a particular frequency that's passed on through from the parent and also, you know, grandparents or somebody. Just somebody. He said, I'm the queen of the army. Oh, my goodness, I tell you. I you know, the way how I live my life with my family and how it has been, I know that's who I was back then. And I, the same person then, same thing that I'm doing now. It's within my soul. And it's not just my blood family, but it's my soul family. You know, I bring people together. I bring things back to life again. And how you bring things back to life again with everything put together is communication, being authentic, you know, keeping it real, being authentic, and allowing each, you know, being able to honor each other for, you know, where we're at in that space. You see what I'm saying? Knowing when to go on timeout and when to come back in, have that time for yourself and when to come back in, you know, you're not neglecting, right, Charlize?
I guess. Hmm. I just like sleep.
Yeah, she does love to sleep. Well, but then again, she stays awake too. Because she
would say, I grind when it's 6 o'clock in the morning. That's the best time.
And why
this was a good talk. I'm gonna listen to my music. Because
I don't have to hear y'all. And there's
people. Excuse me? I beg your pardon?
No, you don't understand. Y'all make so much noise, it's not even funny.
What do you mean make so much noise? How
like would it make noise? Playing music.
Who play music? That's Brandon.
You play music too, but not all the time.
Not all the time.
You always playing your speaking, talking through YouTube or whatever.
That's alright, you'll be alright.
Hold on. Brandon, let me just play the song.
Damn.
I'm winning so
hello.
What you gonna do, dance now?
Ladies. Rap.
Aw, thank you so much. See what you gonna do now.
If you ain't with it, you could leave. We don't need to receive all your hate. I don't care. You just chase and not aware. I don't got nothing with it. That's alright. Finna go sit. If you got a problem, you could take that. Hey, why they hating on Santana? What he do? He sippin' on that Fanta, trying to live his life, you know it now. Uh-huh, we don't clown around, hey. Only know Aquafina, have you seen it? I don't know, around the arena, I feel like a queen. I'm about to blow up everywhere, They gon' hate on me, that's okay, I accept the stairs, hey. If they got a problem, that's alright, I climb the stairs, hey. They just mad because I under like the underwear. But I don't wear out, I don't tear out, I just share everything. This is my apparel, it's a sterile, it's hysterical. The way my lyrical rival twists your system. I'm sorry that this is what you cannot get, I twist it up. Uh-huh, it's a pity that you cannot understand it. Uh-huh, it's a pity that you thinking that you landed, but you never even flew, and you never bought a fly. I'm the sorry, but I took over the highway in the sky, hey. Yes, I'm fly, yes, I'm cool, yes, I'm swaggy, uh-huh. You already know, no need to stop the bragging, uh-uh. Cause if they wanna hate on me, that's cool. Make my green light, cha-cha-chia, can't see me, I'm like CCIA, uh-huh. That's okay, been a takeaway like Tay, hey, hey. Listen to the bars, listen to the beat, that's that major hate. Watch me spin the heat, watch me switch the scene. You can't see me, cause I'm living under the sea with my water and ice, ayy. My ice, I flip it, I switch it like dice. Mm-hmm. 1, 2, 3, alright. Uh-huh. That's okay, I'm never fading. Hey, if you got a problem, take it away. Say K, A. Uh-huh. Yeah. Hey, hey. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. Rugrats back on the scene, and we got the whole place turned up. Can't you see? They sipping on me, they cooking these. You cannot see the way he's spitting heat. So, come on, it's a change of pace. Long decisions, I guess that's how we go away. Uh-huh. Okay, yeah. Uh-huh. Mm. Okay, uh-huh. Cut them off like the top face on the side. Hold on, wait a minute, you know I do not reside. Hey, if you got a problem, you can't chill on my side. Cause we about to pull up, roll up on your squad like a tide. Uh-huh, not the pod, cause we don't pop. Unless there is a problem, cause we be spitting hot. Uh-huh. It's high key, never low key. Don't try to hate on me, cause you just die like low key.
Fire! Wow. See, I like the way she did that so spontaneously, you know what I mean? And for the longest time, you know what, Brandon? She was here smiling too. You know what? Because she picked her own music and everything like that.
Because I didn't have my braces.
And she did. You mean because you didn't have your braces?
No, because you remember my braces.
So
Charlize, please. Give me a broke. Please.
I pick the beat.
You mean you pick the beat? When did you? No, she's the one that.
I searched it.
Oh, you did? Oh, you graduate. Wait, no. You have to take over from Damon
actually,
now?
Actually, Brandon always did it.
I always pick the better beats.
No, no, no.
Chose those freaking stupid electronic
beats, right?
Are so garbage.
No. Anyway. Thank you for being with us this early Saturday morning at 2:05 a.m. Just chilling, you know. Sometimes you just gotta chill, you know. Don't have to be a reason. You know what I'm saying? Things are always happening anyway. And so, oh, I forgot. Today is September 22nd. So we're right, literally at the cusp of the fall season in New York.
I should have to.
So it's a 22 day. So that's what? How much does that add up to? 9 + 4. Plus 11, so that's 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So it's still a 2-2 day. And there's a representation of the equinox, you know? The equinox, where are you in the middle of things in your life and what changes are happening around each and every one of us? And one of the things that I know is a big theme. When I see it as a big thing, your birthday is coming up. When is your birthday? When is your Earth Day? Is that in October? Are you a Libra? So one of the things that that's really huge is relationships. Again, it's been going on, and it's going to be even more intense now for another 30 more days up until about November 16. By the time Venus is the energy's already in retrograde anyway, so. Oh, you're November. Okay. My third son is November also. My granddaughter is also November. So what date is it in November? So yeah, so there's so much that is happening, especially surrounding relationships. I know one thing for sure, one of the clear-cut messages that I received, especially to do with the Defiant Masculine, is that they're starting to feel what the feminine is feeling. They're tapping into their feminine energy more, you know. And there's a saying, he who feels it knows it. And when Yeshua walked the planet, he was able to feel what was happening without having to have had the experience, you know what I mean? So how things are changing now is that you're having your own experience and you're able to feel what the other one is experiencing at the same time. Whoever you're having that experience with, you're able to feel how they feel. You're able to feel how they feel and you know how you're feeling. So it's not one-sided anymore. That's why we're beginning to feel things in all perspectives and have all these energies that are coming up for us, and the veil is so thin. So the masculine is really, really, really starting to feel even more so what the you know, how the feminine is feeling or feeling into one another from the heart space. You know what I mean? And now having to think things through as far as your life, your decisions that you've made. And it's not based on judging. Just love the way she just dances in the background, you know, kind of make you feel balanced with things. That's not all. It doesn't have to be that all serious. You know what I'm saying? Who says you have to deliver a message that you have to be, you know, with a certain background or has to be at a particular time? You know what I mean? There's a lot of things happening every single second of the day. Seriously. I don't have not one ounce of sleepiness in me, but hey, that's it. I just surrender to it, you know? So there's some of us that are stepping in more to our power, and that's where the masculine energy comes in. And then there's some of us who are in more of the masculine energy and really connecting more to that feminine space. And that includes feeling through things, listening to your heart. It's like a lighthearted type of feeling. You know, the inner child is coming in too as well. You know, that childlike feeling, that childlike space, you know. It's everything put together, because we're walking the earth with being the mother, the father, the child, you know, every part of yourself is coming together. So, you know, this is just a part of the cycle. It's just a matter of accepting. So everything what has ever been taught to you is just completely being eradicated. It really, really is. So So take the time to, you keep talking about the ant. We've come together as an ant. Well, we've come together even more so, more even more than the ant also. But it's no coincidence that Godfrey, yeah, you know, and the way how we can relate to each other as a family is be the family yourself, you know, not seeking to have a family necessarily because if you you want to create it in the physical space only, but start to feel it within yourself. And do you recognize your family, even the ones that you're not related to, and people that you come into contact on a daily basis, or whether you work with them or not? Can you see who is your family, and it's not based on the color of your skin and the cultural background and et cetera and et cetera, you know? And how much we are can have compassion for one another. And even though you have compassion, that means you don't suck it up like a sucky bobby and let anybody talk to you the way they feel like it. That you're able to speak up and be in that space of your own strength, learning to say no, you know. And if something doesn't feel right, that you make a conscious choice, you know, living consciously as well. And that means that you're clear, that you're tapping in and connecting to truth and to things that are around you, and not just being plugged into the matrix of how you see things with your physical eyes. So all of these things are important, you know, being able to see and to feel through things without necessarily having the proof, you know. So I'm just in awe, because there's more and more people that are awakened, that are coming my way, that are in contact with me. Especially, I love the ones who are coming from my culture that are awakening. It's just so awesome. Really awesome. I love it. I love it. Oh, excuse me. So how is everyone doing this morning, wherever you are in the world? I hope everyone is doing well. I am in gratitude for that.
It's silly or Kevin's heart.
Oh, so make sure you have some laughter. You know, I was so grateful that Spirit brought me to be able to see Godfrey, because I laughed until tears were coming out of my eyes, and my head was hurting me, and I was just like, it was just so amazing. But that's how he is, you know. So I really would love for any one of you out there to if you have Netflix, to go on Netflix and keep doing a search on Godfrey, because the more people that are searching for him, then he'll be able to get his own show. And you see, remember that coming into this awakening is not just that you're preachy, 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 talking, talking. We're bringing on our awakening. Our talents and our gifts. And so he's a comedian, so he comes through with speaking the truth from laughter, and he also keeps it real, and he doesn't put on a mask, and he's not fake, you know. And that's what attracts me to people, is when you keep it real. Be yourself and be authentic. There's no need to put on a mask, you know what I'm saying? Nobody gives a fuck what you do and where it's taking, because it's time to be truthful about what's going on, and that you're not denying yourself, and you're not denying, you know, God, who you are before him and herself. You see, if it's a fact, it's a fact, and that's it. So for me, when I bring the truth, I bring it with love, especially with love and laughter. And what else, Charlize? How else do I bring the truth? Tell them, how do I bring in the truth as a mother to you?
Rules.
What?
Rules.
Roast?
Rules.
Rules?
I don't know.
You don't know, how do I bring the truth to you? How do I bring the truth to you?
Oh, you curse at
me? She said I curse at her. Oh, well. And what usually works?
If you talk calmly.
She said if I talk calmly, you're right. Because you know what I did as an experiment one day? Since they weren't listening to me, I started to whisper. So I was like... And they're like, what? And I'm like... So I got their attention. Sometimes you have to change things up. You know what I mean? You know, you don't do the same thing all the time. And that's me as an Aquarian. I never do the same thing all the time, because sometimes it just doesn't work. So when you do something different than how you did it the last time, it changes things. You know what I'm saying? The soul was not made to do the same things all the time. Never. Like this, for instance, was spontaneous with her doing that with her hair, because she knows she don't comb her hair when I tell her to, because it gets knotted up and shit. But what happens, I say, experience is the greatest teacher. So she must love when it's I got to dig in her knotted scalp. Really?
It's not.
No, it's not, because it already is. But this is what it's like with us too, you know. And sometimes you can have constructive discussions and it can be heated, but you're still having a discussion. There's nothing wrong with that. So you don't have to keep yourself quiet when you are an expression of the self. Be yourself. Be authentic. Keep it real. Okay? There's no need to hide your feelings. And if you can't express your feelings to someone, I encourage you to, you know, write it down or record it. You know, there's something to that effect. You'll find yourself much feeling much easier with yourself, okay? Because it's not about the other person. It's about you. It's about you, okay? So, yes. So I am going to sign off now. I am in such.
I didn't get to rap to the
beat. Oh, you have another beat you want to rap to?
Right now, which one?
Okay.
Get silly, mo. Don't I tell you?
Ain't which one? That's what it's called. Get one. Silly. Yeah. Oh, I thought he was calling you silly.
You know,
come up with all these names.
I know that scared you, mommy.
That did not scare me.
What about Mega Man?
Shut up. Wait. I like this beat, though. This beat is hard.
Why you like this so much?
Listen to this. Come on. Take it.
I like it, too.
You better go harder.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. Uh-huh. With it, yes, I get silly. You already know, others they just popping pillies, but I'm really trying to get affiliated with the real life. If you got a problem, that's alright, cause you're real, nah. I got so much on me, you know, I got so much money. I'm joking, but I'm finna manifest it in the future. If you got a problem, that's away, cause then you just tweaking. Let the 808 hit you in your face, now you got a speaker. That's alright if you got a problem. That's alright. I don't choose a robin cause I'm like robin. No way I'm moving. You know I'm done. Got my night wings and I'm still flying. I'm bringing it, bringing it, bringing it. Get silly, get silly. If you got a problem, hey, it's a wet willy. Hey, get silly, get silly. Hey, if you got a problem, then we ain't affiliated. Hey, please don't try to change up on me. You just aging. You just mad because I am not your agent. Hey, that's okay, cause this is not detergent. The way that we work is not clean. We are too berserk. Dirty beats, dirty, dirty freestyle. Dirty freestyle. Coastal, coastal, you already know we posted postal. If you got a problem, that's alright, because you know I am not social, so I will not talk to you to fix it. No, I am not, not that. Woo! Jesus Christ, you know that. Lights out, night out, but I still knock your brights out. That's not the real term that you're supposed to say, ay. That's alright, ay. Stop hating, no shame. You crazy. You crazy. Yeah, get silly, ay. Get silly, ay. Get silly, hey. If you got a problem, then that's a will, ay. Get silly. Get silly, get silly, get silly. See me laughing like I'm on the gas, feeling like, hey, I'm about to pass out, but I'm getting right, hey. Get silly, get silly, hey. Get silly, get silly, hey, hey. Feeling like I'm finna pass out, hold on, hit the brakes, get silly.
So you're done?
I don't know if you're aggressive enough for
Megan. Anyway, thank you so much for joining us. I know Charlize is ready to come back and do some lives. You know, she said, you haven't done any lives yet since we moved. So, but either way, thank you so much for being with us this early morning. You know, I love always when it's always, you know, the spontaneity, when we just don't know, you know, we're going to plan to do something. So sometimes that's what life is. You don't have to necessarily plan it. It's just to live it, be in the moment, be in that present moment, always, always, always. And lift yourselves up and, you know, whatever you need to do, because whatever happened 2 days ago and 2 weeks ago and 2 months ago, it's not going to really matter as much, you know. In the next couple weeks or years from now. So that's why it's important to live now and be yourselves. Be yourselves. Be yourselves. That's the best gift you could give yourself. Yes. So thank you so much again. Peace be with you until I speak to you and I'm back on again. Namaste, beautiful souls. Peace.